Get ready to match the star. Dick Gauthier. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Melinda Fee. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rivers!
I think I'm in love with you, Betty.
Oh, John. Thank you, friends. Welcome. You are all welcome.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am, you have a question?
No, what? Show the audience your lining. I got a little peek at it.
I didn't even look at my lining. Oh, yeah.
Is
would
that
you like to see my lining? I'm not a flash or anything like that. I never do this. Is that the way flashers do it?
Yes. That's the way I do it.
I do it like this. Years of training.
Oh, did you see that? Now, wait a minute. That
or
is cool.
This.
All right, look at that. There's a lining.
I have a woman coming twice a week and clean.
Yeah. Nice? No, okay.
Well,
do the best you can.
Do the best you can. She's not doing too bad. All right, shall we have a go at it now?
Sure.
Yeah.
Let's say hello to Katie Heintz and Mike Lurie. Katie's current champ. She's won one game. Has a total amount of cash of $200. She's an undergraduate at San Luis Obispo.
Right.
That's a nice name. Cal State, right?
Cal Poly. Well,
Cal Poly.
Yeah.
What do you study?
Journalism.
Journalism.
Broadcasting.
And broadcasting.
Right.
And you want to be one of those?
Right. I want to be a television broadcaster.
You do?
Yeah.
Do the news and the weather and all that?
Yeah. Yes. If I can.
You can. Yes, you can.
I know I can.
Listen,
okay.
Katie,
no
you
problem.
Can do anything you want to do.
That's right.
Because you're young. You got youth. You got vitality. You got everything. And I want it. No. Now,
I'm
she's being
busted.
Challenged here by Mike Lurie.
Right.
Who's a happy fellow.
He is.
Most happy fellow.
Yes, I am, Jim.
And we're in the middle of round one. See, he's still smiling. He had his first round question, zip, zero. But he's smiling. He's okay. We'll give you your first round question in a moment or so, but right now we want to give you this, especially you. Now we're ready to go on here. Here we go, middle of round one. This is all yours, Katie. Listen carefully, everybody, please. Sheila said...
Yes?
I couldn't afford to get my nose fixed, so I sent away $3 for a do-it-yourself nose job kit. Was I disappointed? All I got was a rubber nose and a blank.
Rubber nose.
That's right.
Sheila's a little butch, isn't she?
Sheila said, I couldn't afford to get my nose fixed, so I sent away $3 for a do-it-yourself nose job kit. Was I disappointed? All I got was a rubber nose and a... really an inspirational piece of literature here,
this
isn't
one
it?
Isn't easy, I'll tell you that right now.
Okay, Rob, you think things were rotten then. Boy, did you see the end of the show here. This lady,
oh, so
while
what?
We're
cares?
Waiting, here, this lady over there. You see, those of you who are addicted to daytime television and never tune in at nighttime, I just want to point out that this pretty gifted lady is seen on The Invisible Man at nighttime. But if you don't tune in nighttime, you wouldn't know that unless I told you. Okay? All right. Charles. Okay. Ready? Katie Heintz.
Right.
Sheila said, I couldn't afford to get my nose fixed, so I sent away for a do-it-yourself nose job kit. Was I disappointed? All I got was a rubber nose and a blank.
A tube of glue.
A what?
Tube of glue.
A tube of glue.
Put the nose on.
Okay. She said a tube of glue, which is quite good.
A tube of glue, I see.
She didn't say a tube, she said a tube.
A tube,
a tube of glue.
That's Swedish, tube of glue.
A tube of glue.
A lot of glue.
Glue, however, harbin, saying the hunger, the frown, the saying a krona freina. It's a kohorna, klona, moon, it's
hey, I got an answer here if you're
what? What do you got there?
I said tube of glue.
Tube of glue. Hey, Katie Heintz.
That's one for you.
Yeah.
One tube of glue for you. What do you say?
How long have we been doing this show? 2 years?
Too long.
Almost
this
3 years
first,
now.
Well, this is probably the first bad answer I've given.
Huh?
That I said she got her a mustache. You know, like they send those little things and they. It doesn't ever come off.
No, they did that to me once. I can't read it. I couldn't get it off for 3 days. Charles?
A strange answer, but adorable.
Well, we'll be the judge of that.
A rubber nose and a rubber scissor.
That's worse than mustache.
Too adorable again?
No.
No. All right. Do-it-yourself nose job. Gimp was high disappointed. All I got was a rubber nose and a tube of glue.
And a jar of glue.
A jar of glue.
Since you've been with us.
That's right.
And now let me explain how she got that match. She copied me. Bottle of glue.
Bottle of glue. So that's three for Katie. Betty White, what do you say?
I haven't had a right one yet this week. I'm still a maiden, as they say.
That'll be the day. We're made in Japan.
It's
A tube of glue is what we want from you.
A nose. I didn't stick to that tube of glue. I said a pair of scissors.
Scissors. Let's hear it for Betty.
Yeah.
Oh.
Leave that girl alone. She's mine.
Well, you're
okay.
Welcome, Joe.
Where are we here? Middle of round, end of round one. Score is 3-0 in favor of the champ. Go to round two. Mike, what is your selection here?
A, please.
A. All right. Mike, everybody plays because he didn't match up in the first round. One bootlegger said to the other, "Hey, this bathtub gin really was made in a bathtub. There's a blank floating in the bottle." Well, what do you think of that?
Did I hurt?
No!
All right.
Very good.
Did he hurt your feelings?
Poor girl.
I'm still hurt, Gene.
Oh, I see. Where's it hurt? Show me where it hurts.
There. Hurts there.
Hurts there.
Hurts there.
Hurts there.
Now the good news. Is everybody happy?
Is everybody happy? Okay, everybody ready? Okay, here we go. Mike Lurie. One bootlegger. You know what a bootlegger is? You're kind of young. You know what bootlegger is.
I remember what they are.
Right.
Yes.
That's why he's so happy.
One bootlegger said to the other, "Hey, this bathtub gin really was made in a bathtub. There's a blank floating in the bottle."
A bathtub stopper.
A stopper floating in the bottle. Okay, Mike. He says a stopper floating in the bottle. What do you say, Dick?
It's really hard to smile when 3,000 people are booing you. I was going to say rubber. No, I said a bar of soap floating.
Bar of soap. Isn't that right? Yeah, that'll do it, Brett.
Poor little devil, there he is, happy as a pig in blank, and it's just he just battens you. I said a bar of very good French soap.
A bar of very good French soap. You used up three cards for that, haven't you?
Yeah. Is there a paper shortage?
Yeah, there is a paper shortage. No, it's just that CBS, you know, it's little. You're going over the budget if you use three cards. What do you say, Charles?
Rubber duck.
A rubber duck. Now, Mike, you got to match three remaining celebrities to stay in the game. Let's see what happens here. Melinda Fee.
Oh, well, I was going to say stopper, but I said a cake of soap.
A cake of soap. Shady wins the game. Soap and soap. Here we go, guys. All right. Mike, what can I tell you? We've got some loot for you, some gifts. Together, don't start turning a thing till I say goodbye to Mike Lurie. Goodbye, Mike Lurie.
Had a nice time. Thank you, Gene.
Thank you, Mike Lurie.
Bye-bye. Goodbye, Happy. Say hello to Grumpy and Duck. And Bashful. And everybody.
Now, Katie, you've got $300, and you're going to have a chance at over $5,000 here. You come back and see how much she wins right after this message. Okay, here we are. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, you've been here before. You know how it goes, so let's get right to it. We polled a recent studio audience, Katie. We got their best response to this. Call me blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. $250 if you match the next one. $100 for the bottom one.
Right.
Whom do you call on?
Brett.
What about call me madam?
That figures.
Okay, there's one.
Okay, Richard.
Call me irresistible.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Okay, call me irresistible.
Going on the air with this.
Is that it? Call me irresistible? The song?
Okay. Isn't that the name of the song?
No, it's irresponsible.
Call me irresponsible then. But call me in the morning.
Call me irresponsible, okay?
Betty.
Up.
Call me up. You frightened me there for a second, so. You got call me up, call me irresponsible, and call me madam. Now, you may have a better idea, Katie. It's entirely up to you now. Make a decision.
How about up? Up?
Call me up. Okay. Call me up. How about up? We'll find out right now. You know, one never knows on this show.
Never.
Call me up is the one she wants. We'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Is it, I ask you, in all fairness, under the $100 response? Call me sometime.
Call me sometime.
No. Call me.
No, that's call me irresistible.
Call me. Call me up is what we want, folks. Let's see if it's under the $250 response. Call me irresponsible.
You laughed when I sang to you.
All right. Last chance for call me up. You think it's going to be madam or up?
Madam.
Madam.
Really?
Al madam.
All right. Slide it, Earl.
Yeah, it is.
Madam it is.
Why didn't you trust me? Hey, I'll bet she's so young, she's never heard of Call... Have you never heard of Call Me Madam?
Have you heard the show?
You heard of that song I sang.
It was a big Broadway musical called Call Me Madam. You never... You remember that?
No.
How old are you, Katie?
19.
You wouldn't remember that. When was that on Broadway?
Oh, long before I was born, dear.
Sure it was. All right, Katie, I'm sorry you didn't win any money, but you got another chance because you're going to meet another player right now. Let's welcome Sedalia Jones. Okay. Sedalia, you know Katie? Well, Sedalia, we welcome you, and we ask you to tell us a little bit about you, where you're from, and all that sort of thing.
I'm from Los Angeles. I'm a programmer analyst during the day. I go to school at night. I have two little boys and a husband. We've been married 12 years.
Okay. And what do you study at night?
Math.
Math. Yes. Are you going to continue in the programming and the computer field?
Yes, I am.
It's a very interesting field. Good luck to you, Sedalia. We'll push the button and reveal our first round questions, ask you to make a selection.
B.
B, we go again. Don't get them dirty.
I certainly would.
Are you warm enough, dear?
I must say. You know, about a month ago, you remember the time somebody in the audience said, those are beautiful socks. I'd like to get a pair for my husband. And I said, I don't think you can buy these anymore. And I took my socks off and I gave them to the lady.
You certainly did.
And some kind lady here brought these to me. She said, I saw you give your socks away and I thought you'd need another pair, so I brought these. Right. But these have toes in them.
Right.
Yes.
By the way, I gave my undies away last week.
Yeah.
Are you embarrassed?
No, friend. Don't want any mail. Don't want any visitors to the studio with boxes of underwear and
well,
none of
I
that
do.
Stuff. Yeah. No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't. Now, listen
yes,
to this.
I do.
Now, here, I have a little limerick for you. Sedalia, listen here. An animal lover named Blair said I used to be wild about Cher. She gave me her cat, her snake, and her rat, but she won't let me play with her blank.
Once more into the breach, Joey.
Once more into the breach.
I'm done.
He's done, you see. He's so quick.
Sedalia.
Used to be wild about Cher. She gave me her cat, her snake, and her rat, but she won't let me play with her.
Oh, once I saw it written down.
The rhyme scheme is Blair, Cher, right.
Mayor, there.
Okay, you got it. You got it. Those two are ready. Everybody ready downstairs? So we'll come over here to Sedalia Jones.
Well.
There once. An animal lover named Blair said, I used to be wild about Cher. She gave me her cat, her snake.
What? My fault. Just a minute.
What? What was that?
Be quiet.
Well, you got the little orchestra.
A little orchestra in here.
The little orchestra.
I'm sorry. They're rehearsing. We're going to do Dinah right after this.
Dinah Shore next door? Tony Orlando? What's going on? An animal lover named Blair said, I used to be wild about Cher. She gave me her cat, her snake, and her rat, but she won't let me play with her...
Hair.
Yes? I used a lot of restraint. I did not say pear.
Oh, you didn't.
I didn't. No. No, I said...
You've blown the joke for him, though.
Oh, I said hair.
Hair. Brett, what do you say?
Well, I didn't even think of pear. I just came right out and said hair.
Hair. That's stupid today. Charles?
Since she's a math major, 2 + 2 = hair.
Okay. Wait for Sedalia. Melinda B., my dear.
Well, I'm along with everybody else. I said hair for Cher.
Okay. Hair, Cher, Blair. All the rhyme schemes are there. Now, Richard.
You've got to have hair. Oh, you're really, really.
The only thing that I... first of all, I'm disassociating myself with this entire company altogether. But the only thing you have to remember, it was an animal story, right?
Right.
Your bat and her... So her hair is that kind of a hair.
Hair. Okay. Okay. Now, Sedalia, you can't do better than that, and it's most unusual for a round one question. So you just lay out while she does her first and second round questions, and the best she can do is tie you, and we'll see how that turns out after we see about this. Pay attention. Here we go. Shall we carry on? All right. Katie Hines, it's all yours. At the sideshow, the India rubber man got engaged to the fat lady.
And what happened?
Instead of giving her a ring, he tied his blank around her finger.
That's the Indian rubber man?
The India rubber man. They're part of circuses and carnivals, you know all that. And the fat lady is also part of the circus, you see. Instead of giving her a ring, he tied his blank around her finger. You know, the India rubber men, they were very limber fellows. You got the idea? Have you got the idea?
Yeah, I think so.
You've rejected it.
I reject all my organs.
Very good.
My pen.
I would do that.
I play it safe.
Yes. Splendid. Okay.
Charles isn't ready.
Charles is not quite ready. He'll be ready in a moment or so.
Betty is not ready.
Okay, now we are ready. Katie Hines at the sideshow. The India rubber man got engaged to the fat lady. Instead of giving her a ring, he tied his blank around her finger.
Himself, his body.
His whole body.
Well, yeah, he tied himself around
okay.
her finger. She's fat.
All right. Right.
He's limber.
How bad is she?
How bad?
What'd you say, Dick?
What did I say?
What did you say? You remember what you said?
I love this answer. No, I said he tied his finger around her finger.
Tied his finger around her finger. That's good. Okay.
Let's hear it for that, folks.
Stretching a point. No. He wanted to be led around by the nose.
Tied his nose around her finger. Oh. She loved it, didn't she?
You like that one, Vic?
I thought it was swell.
Charles, what did you say?
In Indian, we say, which means that's a crummy question. So I have a crummy answer, lachinya, leg.
Katie Hines said, tied his body around her finger. What do you say, Melinda, my dear?
Well, out of all the parts, I chose finger.
Finger. Okay.
Rubber finger.
Right. Okay, tied his finger around a finger. That's a good response.
My second choice was tongue.
All right. Betty White.
You want to know what my first
No, thanks.
I'll tell you later.
All right, now, cool it.
Is there any chance of sitting someplace else in this game sometime?
You know, sometime, yes. We can move you around a little bit.
Strangely enough, I said Lichinya, but I didn't even know I spoke.
Legs.
You didn't hear you spoke? Hindi, that is. He's speaking Hindi. Pure Hindi there. Where are we here? End of round one, 6-0 the score. You can have another shot at it, but right now we want to have a shot at you and this commercial. Now, I guess we're going to have to wait until next time to see how this resolves itself. 6-0 the score here. You got one more shot at it to achieve a tie. And we thank you, ladies. And we'll look forward to seeing you next time, as we will all of you celebrated and gifted and beautiful
people. Do we get to
come
back tomorrow?
Yes.
Oh, I'm so glad.
Well, we're out of sync, so I'm not quite sure when it is. But you will come back. Gene Rayburn here, Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.